Ryan of V1 Engineering showed us a trick for checking for square in which you put blue painter's tape on the corners and install a very sharp V-bit in your LowRider. Let me come around and get a better view of it. There you see is the very sharp V-bit. And when you bring the LowRider down, it pokes really tiny holes in the painter's tape.
When you compare your two diagonals, there are two ways to correct for being out of square. One way is physically adjusting end stops, and the other is software.
You can use the M666 G-code to save an offset in Marlin, and you can use the GRBL pull-off, which is a per-axis attribute, to set and account for square. That's a software way of dealing with it. But then if your end stops are like mine, adjustable, you can account for the offset physically. Now, if you're doing that, it helps to either have some marks designed into your item or manually added to your adjustable end stop like I've done here. So those little black marks, the one on the left is where I started, and the one on the right is where I've ended up. Each time that you measure, I started off measuring, and then each time I measured, I would write down what my diagonals were. And you can see my fourth attempt, fifth, sixth, my seventh attempt that I made just a moment ago. So I've just now adjusted my physical end stop again. So I'm going to show you the process that I'm using to measure my diagonals. This is using a Jackpot board with FluidNC firmware, which is GRBL compatible. My process involves first homing the machine, which is done with this button right here. After I home the machine, I probe. I actually have two probe scripts that are identical, except one uses G92 and one uses G10. You can use either one. But so I home the board, then I probe down to the spoil board. Then I run a G-code script that I've named Square. And what that does is it has four points programmed into it. One on this corner of the board, one on that corner of the spoil board, one on that corner of the spoil board, and one on that corner of the spoil board. It goes to each of those locations and drops that sharp V-bit down into the tape, then moves up and then moves over and repeats. And after doing it on the last one, it returns back to the corner here. I use my phone with the LED light turned on, shining it down under on the tape as I watch it penetrate so that I can see where it went, because the hole can be kind of tiny and hard to see. Let me get my Tiny Touchplate out. Turn on the Jackpot. Give it a moment for its Wi-Fi network to come up and connect to the FluidNC Wi-Fi. Go to a browser and go to 192.168.0.1, and let me refresh just to make sure that I'm connected. And then I will home the machine. Okay, now that homing is complete, I need to move over on this axis by 30 millimeters and over on this axis by 20 millimeters to get lined up for probing. So I will go 2, 3, 2. All right, so now I'm lined up for probing. The next thing is to run my probing script. It's coming down. I'm holding my Tiny Touchplate in place. That really sharp V-bit will come down and probe. It will touch off twice. There's the first one, and there's the second one. Now I will put away my Tiny Touchplate. And then I will run my squaring script. Here we go. Okay, you saw it come down on the first one. There's the second one. There's the third one. And there's the fourth one. So now I'll use my tape measure to measure my diagonals and make sure that I'm where I want to be. And again, I can either offset physically or using software. This has been Doug with Design8 Studio. And until the next video, I wish you happy making.